Hello, this is Rob from Reams Models. This is my first update of the Tamiya Tiger 1 mid-production. Before we start, big thank you to all my subscribers. All your comments, really do appreciate it. Now here I'm just showing you a quick look at the parts. Really nice kit, really detailed. This is the exterior only. There's no internals. There's four of the sprues, and then you got three of the track sprues. So as you know, there's enough parts to keep you busy for a bit. You got a couple of barrels as well, which are in two halves, so you got to glue them together. Right, first. We're starting on the lower hull, the suspension arms. You've got eight. One, two, three, four, five. Eight each side. And there's little pins, where you can see where I'm putting the glue. There's little holes there to help you keep them all in line. Really positive fit. I'm really, really liking these Tamiya kits. The engineering on them are excellent. Okay. So you just do exactly the same on the other side. We can see the locating holes. These parts I'm fitting here are both the same number, so all you gotta do is just make sure you get them the right way up. Again, you can't go wrong. Instructions are nice and clear as well. Okay, now we're working on the back plate. Just dry fit, just to make sure it fits. No problem, fits beautiful. As you can see, look, just falls into place. And I'll fit it first, then I'll put the glue. Right, now we're starting on the wheel assembly. Right, so you got your idlers and sprockets. There's little pins just to help you keep them in line. But all you gotta do is just make sure the teeth are in line, because your tracks won't fit. Three parts to these. Again, little pins just to help you line it up. A good thing about these as well, on the sprockets, the actual attachment points are on the end of the teeth, so it really makes it easy to clean them up. Right, we've got eight of each set of wheels. And also on the wheels as well, there's the little numbers moulded in. So you can't get mixed up. All you gotta do is just make sure you get them the right way around. A little bit of clean up to do. But I always glue the wheels together, and then I'll clean them once they're all glued together. That was just there, was just showing you all the wheels fitted. Now we're starting on the exhaust now. Two of these. They are quite fiddly. There's six parts to each one. But what I do off camera as well, I I use the Mr. The what's her name to make a like a you stipple it on to give it a bit of a rushed effect. You're only going to see the top bit because once the shrouds are fitted on. Okay, all you gotta do, just make sure as well you get them the right way. There's little, plenty of little guiding holes and pins to help you line it all up. Okay, so now we're fitting the top piece. Okay, a little bit fiddly. Well, as you can see, all I'm doing here now is just lining it up because one of the pins have come out. Well, like I said, you got two of them. Right, now we're working on the jack. There's three parts to this. You just glue the two parts here. And then when you glue the jack on to the back of the tank, you got the handle and you fit on. This fit here is beautiful. I always test fit my parts just to make sure that they fit okay. Well, as you can see, just clicks into place. Some really nice weld detail as well on this. Also, I don't glue too many parts on because I've got to do the Zimmerit yet. Well, I'll show you how I do that when I get to it. I'm just working on the inside now. All you'll see is just this little bit sticking through. You haven't got to worry about painting the inside of this because you're not going to see it. I'll have the hatches shut as well, so you ain't really going to see inside. But the one hatch on the turret I'll have open because it comes with a commander. Okay, so that's that. I see it's workable as well, so just be careful with your gluing. Still gluing parts on onto the upper hull. I can see there's plenty of holes to help you locate where the stuff goes. There's a few little holes to drill here and there, but the majority of them are done. Right, this is the hatch assembly for the engine. There's four parts to glue onto this. The little handles, which you'll see in a minute, I'll cut them off with sprue, then I attach them, and then when they've dried, I'll sand them off while they're in position. Just makes it easier because they are quite hard to hold and without snapping them, so it's just as easy just to sand them in position. You've got two of them. Now, because there's no engine detail, I should just have it glued shut. Okay. So now that the lower hull and the upper hull are not glued together yet. Because I will pull it apart when I come to fit the Zimmerit. Okay. These as well, I'll fit the tools and I should glue all them in position and then paint them once I've painted all the tank. I haven't decided yet which scheme to do. I've got an option here. I could either just do the normal three-tone camo, or there's a nice two-tone camo, or there's a winter one as well. Right, these now are your two hatches. So there's a right and a left. So if you have your hatches open, then there's little handles and levers and that to glue on. But because I've got it shut, I don't bother. I've got to fit this because they poke up through on the through the hatch. So you will see that. We can get a full crew set for this. This one only comes in one figure. So it's still working on the internal detail. Right, now we're fitting the hatches. Again, just making sure you get them the right way, because you can get these the wrong way around. I've got to say, this Tamiya plastic is beautiful to work with. Really nice to sand up. Glues really well. This is just gluing the jack block on now. And the good thing about this kit as well, you nearly use all the parts. There's not many parts left. The only awkward bit was the tracks. But once you got stuck in, they went together pretty well. So I glued in the other tower cable on. You can buy aftermarket sets for these, but I'm building this straight out the box. Okay, so we're still working, still gluing parts. I don't show you every piece as well being glued on. There's just too many in it. You can't see a lot of them because they're that small. This is the fire extinguisher. But still keep in mind, I haven't glued the two together yet. Okay. You can see there's plenty of holes. You can't really get it wrong. I shall definitely be building more Tamiya kits in the future. And if they're all as good as this, I'm really looking forward to starting them. I'm looking forward to the weathering and the painting, the weathering stage. I look forward to. It's one of my favourite parts is the weathering. Well, I do like it all actually. The actual building, the painting, and the weathering. Well, now we're starting on the turret. There is a little bit of turret detail. But to be honest, you're not going to see it. Because I only had the one hatch open. And with the figure in there, you can't really see much. But I do spray it just in case. Now this fits together beautifully. And if you're careful with your gluing, it is workable. So the bit and gluing here is the actual inside. This was a little assembly I built there, and all it was 2, 3, 4 parts which I glued together. There's two halves and then these two bits I'm putting on. Just keep making sure you get it the right way around. And all that as well, you can only get one way, so you can't get it the wrong way. Right, still working on the turret now. These parts go together beautifully. You just got a couple of little ejector pins to get rid of, and then once you've sanded that flat, beautiful fit. These here I'm fitting because the figures rest on them. Okay, so don't glue this piece on. As you can see, look at that fit. Beautiful. And it's workable. So you don't just glue up where I'm gluing this bit and then the back, and you'll have a workable gun. Them little tabs on the back is where the turret basket will go. Right, you got a choice here of the two barrels. There's a bit of, once you've glued it together, there is a little bit of a seam. But a few swipes with your knife and your sanding stick, it's gone. No problem at all. You can buy a metal gun barrel. But to be honest with you, you can't tell. Once you've sanded it down. Okay, so we're still gluing parts on the turret. Okay, now that hatch as well, you can have open. And there's a bit of detail on the hatch. And the only problem with them is there is some little ejector pin marks on them, which I think could be quite fiddly to get off. But they are very slightly raised, so you could sand them down. Okay, so the turret's actually nearly finished now. There's a few more little parts. This was quite difficult to clean up. There you go. It was really awkward to roll to sand it down. Right, now we're working on the turret basket now. This is the underneath. The hatch detail and that's already moulded on. So you can't really have this open. It's only in two parts. But it's beautifully moulded. I don't actually glue this on yet because I've got to do the Zimmerit yet. Okay, see? Beautiful fit. And all this is now, this is the one I have open. This is the commander's hatch and the cupola. Right, now this is the Zimmerit now. This is the actual Tamiya Zimmerit coating. Now, I've never used this before and it was quite fiddly. It's actually adhesive, you stick it on. But the only problem was where all the little bits, the holes were and that, you had to cut them out yourself. There wasn't pre-cut, so it was quite fiddly, but once you get the hang of it, it's all right. So all I did was just roughly cut the holes out and then fit it and then get a sharp knife and just trim them. Well, this is the first piece I'm fitting. And it is fiddly. I don't say it's not, but it is. But once it's stuck down, it ain't coming off. And you get spares with this as well, plenty of spares. Okay, so I don't know if you can make it out, but that's all the Zimmerit on the lower hull fitted. Just got to do the front there. And all you got to do is just drill the holes out. Well, when it's painted, it looks really, really effective. If I was going to do it again, I'd try a different Zimmerit. I'll try one of the ones that are already pre-cut. Because they do a photo etch version as well, so I don't know what that would be like. But this one, it was alright. It was a lot of work. So we just, because I now have got it fitted, I can glue all the parts on there. And what I'll do off camera, I've just roughly cut it. I should go around and just trim it up. Just making sure there's no bits sticking out where I've missed. Okay. Okay, so now we're fitting the shrouds. Once these are on, you're not going to see a lot of the exhaust look. And these are handed as well. So when you cut them off, just keep them separate. So you know which way is which. You can damage all this up. I don't. I keep it clean. But you can dent them and that. You can actually buy photo etch of these. And you can bend them all out of shape and that. To fit that Zimmerit with all that glued on would have been really difficult. Now this is a shovel now on the front. These two holes you have to drill. So just watch your instructions because you'll miss it, but it tells you to drill two holes. Okay. I was still working on the lower hole. There's only one of these, it only goes on one side. Okay, so now this is the spare tracks. Now there's what you got to check, there's two types on the sprue. You got the normal ones, and these have got little pins on just to help you with locate them. So you just make sure you get the right ones. Well, I just think it's going to be easier painting these when they're in position. So you got five this end and two the other end. As you can see, that they look really nice. There is some little ejector pin marks which you've got to get rid of. Excuse me. I don't bother so much on the main tracks because by the time you've weathered it, you're not going to see them. So I'm just gluing the turret basket on. It'll only go on one way. Okay, so we're just working on the skirts now. They're both the same number, so you can't get them mixed up. Again, you can get these in photo etch, so you can damage them up. And well, I must admit, I do like the look of the clean builds. Okay, so I'm just showing you the tracks now. You got 100 links each side. So what you gotta do, you just put them in a line. Just drop them together and then you just glue it all, leave it to set for a little bit, and then just wrap the tracks around. They are really fiddly. Once I got going with them, they went really well. So that's them all together. So all I'm doing is just running the glue each link. And then just make sure you got them all straight as well. So off camera, I'll just straighten them. Okay, so I'll leave them for about 5 minutes. And then all I'll do then is just slide them on. Make sure you got them the right way as well, because the one end's wider than the other. They're still quite manageable. Don't leave them too long. It says that in the instructions, it says an half hour to an hour. And if you leave them that long, I don't think you'd move them. I like to glue the tracks off separate and paint them and that, but I think it would have been a bit difficult. Okay, so that's it. That's it finished. So, just like to say a big thank you. I hope you enjoyed the build. The final reveal will be coming up soon. If you like what you see, please don't forget to subscribe. And keep commenting, because I do like to read your comments. So thank you, and I'll catch you in the next update.